begotten of the Holy Spirit, that in us is Christ. A son of God, therefore, formed in us. And when this earthly body dissolves, saying it again, this spiritual body comes from the bowels of the earth. There's another body waiting to receive it. If this earthly tabernacle is dropped, there's another body to receive it. This mortal body puts on immortality. This terrestrial puts on celestial. See what I mean? There's a natural body that's sinful, but isn't meant just like it's another body that we go to. And I am so grateful to God that I can say, as your pastor and brother, I see those people, so help me in that body and under them with my hands. But I want to go beyond that of time. So let me say, they are real. The same way I see you, I can touch you. He was there, everybody was coming. I would bless you with my passion. It's not that it's true anymore, it's a reality. Yes. Amen. Say, so you are outworld of man, which is controlled by success. Now, for instance, Jesus made a statement, a promise. The inside man says that it's true. The outside man reasons that it can't be true to you. When, and then ignore the outside man and accept the inside man. Now, that's the same thing that Paul speaking, he was sold under the law of carnal sin. Every one of us is the same. That's the reason we have the troubles we do. Of man for 4 or 5 times, and this and that, all kinds of sin and adulteries and everything else around in our lives is because of those things. We are carnal. And that part must perish. But then inside we are a spirit man. So inside, and that's faith in God's word. Amen. Amen. Then we bring our outside body under subjection to the word by faith, by accepting what God says. We don't have anything to tell God. We don't have anything. But the man said, if you go outside here, you take the car and go. You don't need the guidance. You don't need the navigator. Why? Because we know the road. And if I take you somewhere in Africa, you need the guide. Mm-hmm. Why? Because you don't know the place. But the man said, we don't need someone to teach us how to steal. Everyone is a thief. Guilty. We are a sinner. Everyone, you don't need someone to tell you how to forget someone. How to be selfish. It's easy because you know it already. But somewhere you don't know, you need someone to guide you. Amen. That's the reason we need God had to send a prophet to tell us about him. We didn't know about this thing. Because everything was covered by the black cloud. We could not see. But when the word of God has been preaching to us, we come to recognize, I'm not from this world. I'm the son of God. Yeah. I must live this one. I must work in that way. Mm-hmm. See? We need a guide. That's the reason we don't use your 5 senses. The only thing your 5 senses can do for you is going to be strong.
That's right.
Everything is not about the five senses. Let's take the blind Bartimaeus. He was a blind. Caiaphas was a man who could see. He took eyes open wide. The Messiah was there. He said, Beelzebub, blind Bartimaeus, he came and said, thou son of David, have mercy on me, without any eyes.
Yes.
We need the super sense. To see Jesus. Yeah. Every promise of God is nothing to do about these eyes. Yeah. Forget about it.
Right.
Even the rapture, nothing to do with these eyes. You can't see anything. Nothing will change. Because if it's let's say this when Jesus Christ came. Jesus Christ didn't came only for the people who could see. He came for the blind also.
Yeah. Yeah.
How the blind can see Jesus? Jesus Christ knew that he put in the eyes, the super sense in them, the supernatural eyes in the heart, what they can you want to know about the word of God, you must read it. Just read it. Come to the church. Let's say the pastor is preaching. Now, the only way for us to have the Spirit of God, we must have the life of God in us. See, how can I take a copy of God? For the French speakers, how do you call it? Gratéon. He said, I call God and make a grain of wheat of out of it. It's impossible for me to do it. The only way it can be is because inside that cup of God has been transmitted from a cup of God with cup of God to a gem called wheat life. Then you buy that cocoa bar and it will produce a grain of wheat. That's right. Because there has been a life of wheat put in the cocoa bar.
Amen.
See, coming. And the life of the cocoa bar has been taken out. But the nature of the cocoa bar again is still sticking. See. I said, what about in here? We must be patient to ourselves and to the people. We are not working the same idea. Some of them, they are fast. Some of them, they are coming very slow. So just need to help each other. Amen. And it will be this, he said, yes. You see, there is the. It's still sticking because we're still in this flesh. And it will be until this new life has fully been developed out of the ground and went up again. When it comes forth, there is no more cover ground. Amen. But wheat. But while it's still on earth, in out of the earth and up, cover ground is still sticking, but it's called the nature on the inside of me. Amen. And the Son of God. So the wheat typifies Jesus Christ. And as long as you are in this life, you're going to be sticky and have a carnal nature that's going to bother you as long as you live. But the inside of you, you form again.
Amen.
And when you raise up, you're in the likeness of Christ. Amen. And all the sin is gone from you. See, that's the thing. Praise be to God.
Amen.
I don't say that, so just contact back like the world. Do your best to stay with the word of God. Where you are weak, God will help you. Amen. Remember, they control the earth now. But he was created to lead the universe. That's the man was created to lead the universe. To be the master of the nature. Masterpiece. Now, who's the light? What I want to say here in the message called Masterpiece. It's talking about the artist, Michelangelo. Michelangelo, the way he called him. He was an artist, he was building the statue of Moses. From the piece of marble. And the people saw it and said, how this man can get Moses out of this piece of marble? But the man said, it was because,
amen.
Because he was just taking the path to what if the path to what wasn't Moses out of the marble. And the rest was Moses. It's what the Lord of God is doing with you. He's just taking the path what is not Christ. Finally, you see Christ will appear there. I remember when Fred came, remember again last time when we went to distribute the leaflet, we saw a man who was carving, doing the scripture. An artist was telling us, this is me, this is my wife, this is my children. Okay? I didn't see anything. But he had a picture in his mind. mouth of God. When God says, He says definitely. When He has seen my practice, when I want to see you, see just a man with your weaknesses. But when God says you will see, He's going to see the masterpiece, He's going to come out.
Amen.
See, but let us, what I'm saying is speaking here, under paragraph 101. But let us not forget that in the beginning, when it's more the side of Adam, He took something from his side. Now, the smiting of Christ was for a cause that He might take from him one to be a family, the bride. He might take him a bride. So when his masterpiece was perfected, when he had to smite it to take from him not another piece, not another creation, but of the same creation. My brother, don't think back at this, but think a minute. If he took from him the original creation to make the bride for him, he never made another creation. He took a part of original creation. Amen. Then if he was the word, what must be the bride be? It's got to be the original word, living God in the world. That's what is the bride, the Son of God, because it's necessary. See, so you can call it how you want, but it's just the same thing. But it's necessary. See, the Son of God. 1:5. You see, the masterpiece must be cut. Notice, cut for what? Is the piece cut off? No. The piece that's cut off is made of a victorial needle.
The Bible said we are sons and daughters of God.
his offspring. Now, there was something like God was. Amen. Just said to himself, it's written, you are God's. Written in your law, you become a part of God, a son of God by adoption through Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. But the Bible says, it's saying that what's taking place here? But the Bible said the darkness, the blackness melt the soul. Now the word of God just is the light. What is doing? Just pushing away all those black clouds to make appear the Son of God again. He said, in the book of John, the fourth chapter, Jesus speaking to a woman at the well. But Abraham said he was contacting his spirit. He was manifesting to her, trying to move the dark cloud and make the S-O-M to shine again. Mm. One day, he passed through Samaria, the third seal, 1962, paragraph 229. One day, he passed through Samaria, going down through them with a bunch of Jews. He left them, and this little feminine woman came out, maybe a pretty little lady, you know, and she being found out on the street as a king, and she was going through there. A job. She looked around and there said, kind of middle-aged Jew. She said, aren't you a Jew? You shouldn't do that. It's not customary for you to talk to me. It's a Samaritan. He said, but if you know who you are talking to, you ask me to give you a drink. She said, where's your bucket? Where's your string? He said, the water that I give is life. The what? Why? She said, why you all want to worship in Jerusalem and our fathers worship them? Now, the big thing what I want to show you is, when she began to study, you know, he said, go get your husband and come here. She said, my husband, I haven't got any husband. You know the story? Paragraph 2036. What was it? He said, that light struck that seed that had been laying there that was spoken by God. Yes, sir. The seed was in hell. When God moved the water away and the sun hit it, it came up. That's why. That all it needed was S-U-N. It needed light, yes, sir. And then when the Holy Spirit in him moved away the past life, see that the black cloud, the past life, and showed it to her. The light struck him. She said, sir, I receive your prophet. Amen. The Messiah comes that what is going to be, and we have had a prophet for hundreds of years. I don't understand this, said the Messiah coming from where he's going to do that. Later, but who are you? He said, I am that was.
Yes.
That was it. I have. See, the seed. I don't have enough time. I'm going to jump something. So because I'm going to jump something else here. Just two more paragraphs. Closing. Question and answer, 1964. Number 3, paragraph 242. Just actually, but someone asking the question to the bottom here. We must know. He said, please explain the mystery of the translation of the light. But what I'm speaking, he said, just a change of our bodies. He said, Abraham was looking for a promised son that was promised to him. Is that right? And the church is looking for a promised son, the son of God we're talking about here.
Amen.
The bride, is that right? The bride is looking for the promised son. Before the promised son could come to Sarah and Abraham, their bodies had to be changed in them. Is that right? She was too old to have a baby. He had the main vent, he had breast. Her breast was dried up, her womb wasn't fertile, she was sterile. She could not have the baby. Her heart was too old to stand labor. So what happened? God changed her back to a young woman. And he did Abraham the same thing, because he said his body was as good as dead. And he had to change the body in order to receive the promised son. And we cannot receive the promised son that's promised us. Promised us today in these bodies that we live in. These bodies are sin. This first conscious controls body, we read it already. It's not this outside sickness, face, men, and him. Is it subject to death and will die? But the inside part of you, down in here inside, that's in the person that can die. That's the person that the new life starts from this new birth, and it builds another person in the image of this person you are around that life. The seed was this. Jesus Christ was the word of God. The Logos came in the very womb, created a man who was walking. That should be able to eat. The same thing. When the word of God you are eating now is going to be manifest, it's going to create another body. Where you are going to stay. Amen. So potentially, I'll finish. So potentially it's here. And what is it? The word promised before the foundation of the world. And around there, this only reflects the negative. That will reflect the positive. The word. See, and the same thing is the translation of the Bible will be the same thing. The word that's in you. The body will materialize around that word, and the same thing did my Sarah before when that old body that she had, the first body. Mm-hmm. It had to be changed in order to produce a son. You get that body could not be do it. This body cannot do it. So it has to be changed the same way to receive the Son of God. Every atom must be changed.
Yeah.
Praise be to God. That's why the Bible says the revelation, the rapture is the revelation. When the body change is going to take place, there must be some things taking place already in you. In the rapture also is the process. We are eating. When I was a child, I used to be like Jesus. I was like you, Jesus. Like just a little boy. After eating, every time eating. Fufu. All that food. That's when you see a man like me here, it's a result of fufu. Shima. It's a result of the food. If I wasn't eating, I didn't eat. I should not be here.
Right.
Because I was eating. I'm not eating a packet of food at the same time. A little. Scripture upon scripture. You are building something. You are building the human. You are building the glorified, but everything. The last one, I'm going to leave the church for this one I'm closing. That's the end. Somebody told me, but I was speaking in 19th, question and answer, in number 4, 1964, paragraph 36. Somebody told me he had one time was converted, received the Holy Ghost, and he said to him, how are you getting along? He said, pretty good, pretty bad. He said, well, how do you mean pretty bad and pretty good? He said, well, since me received the Holy Ghost, he said, let's bring two dogs in me. And one of them a black dog, and one of them a white dog. And said, they argue all the time. Think of the believer. When the pastor is saying, think of the believer in the church, don't try to see the same. No, it's about yourself.
Amen.
Unbeliever. Make believer spirit. The believer is wrong. In the church of Elbow and Cain, they were just sheep. And said, said they argue all the time. Said they go and fight at one another. And said the white dog wants me to do. They want me to do good. The black dog wants me to want me to do bad. Said, watching which one of them wins the fight. Now the answer is very important. Said that depends on which one chief feels the most. So I think that's a good answer here. See, that just depends on the world of the body that's in you. It depends on which one you are carnal to, which nature you carnal to. The carnal nature after the things of the world, or the spiritual nature after the things of the world, the God, or the thing of God. That's it. Amen. So you have chosen. So I've jumped so many people here. God bless you.
Amen.
Just going to, how much time have you left me? Probably. No, that was a good answer.